Parents, relatives, and friends of class of 2020, welcome to Sharpsville Area High School. Commencement is the academic ceremony backed by nearly thousands of years of tradition and history. It is the day of celebration that calls for a high level of dignity and respect. Thus, we respectfully request your cooperation in giving the ceremony the reverence it deserves by providing an opportunity for all of our graduates to be appropriately recognized. I first want to thank Allison Saylor, Deja Springer, John Benoit, Ellen Keller, Jordan Mastriangelo, Dina Myers, Crystal Miller, Karen Zager, Kirk Skirpa, Aaron Meredith, Wade Hoagland, and Andy Coaches, and the entire maintenance staff and crew for their help in planning this evening's event. Please join me in thanking them for their efforts. You will note that our seniors with gold cords are honor students. The students wearing red and white cords are recognized for their Skills USA members for the Career Center. The students wearing the burgundy and white medals are recognized for their advanced scores on the Career Center NOCTI. And students wearing blue and white cords are members of the National Honor Society. The valedictorian and salutatorian are identified by a gold sash that they are wearing. Again, we would ask for your cooperation in keeping the program dignified and honored, thereby holding all applause and other forms of individual recognition until the appropriate time. The class of 2020 truly appreciates your cooperation in honoring their traditions. Pictures will be taken by Matt Driscoll Photography and will be available online for purchase. You may also come to the front of the bleachers by the rail if you would like to get a close picture of your graduate as they are getting their diploma. At the end of the ceremony, please remain standing until all of the faculty have proceeded off the field. Parents and guardians, you may meet your student at the softball field at the conclusion of the ceremony. Thank you. And now it is with pleasure that I present to you the class of 2020. Please remain standing for the singing of God Bless America and our national anthem.
Gallantly streaming, and the rocket.
You may be seated. At this time, I would like to ask Senior Class President Emma Haywood to the podium.
Sharpsville has always been a place I've been proud to call home. A place where the community cares about the people in it. A place where the town dedicates a day to the class of 2020 because they lost the end of their senior year. This school is a place where the teachers and administration not only helped to make sure we got a quality education, no matter how difficult it was, but also gave us a safe haven to come to for anything we needed help with. For a unique class like this, it was important that the staff gave us compassion and so many second chances. Speaking for all of us, we thank all the great teachers we have for what they have sacrificed for us. Although we spent the last few months of school apart physically, we were still going through it together with the Blue Devil spirit and pride people have always talked about. This journey has not been easy, to say the least, but now we can take a deep breath and know that we are stronger moving forward. Thank you, Sharpsville, and congrats to the class of 2020.
It is our policy to recognize the top five students in the senior class for scholastic achievement. I wish to congratulate these students on their fine work, and I ask each of them to stand as their name is called. The following students have graduated the top five of their class and will receive an award. Please rise as your name is called and approach the podium. Graduating fifth in the class is Shauna Hartwick. Shauna plans to attend Penn State University main campus and major in aerospace engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, Shauna Hartwick. Graduating fourth in the class is Joshua Stevenson. Joshua plans to attend Carlo University and major in biology with early acceptance to Lake Erie College of Medicine. Ladies and gentlemen, Joshua Stevenson. Graduating third in the class is Jared Clemenson. Jared plans to attend Grove City College. His major is mechanical engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, Jared Clemenson. Our salutatorian graduating second in the class is James Misavage. James plans on attending Penn State University main campus to major in chemical engineering. Ladies and gentlemen, James Misavage.
Expected. This is the way our year ends, as T.S. Eliot said, not with a bang, but with a whimper. We lost our prom, our musical, and our spring sports seasons. To top it all off, we've lost the true graduation celebration we've seen in previous years and longed for. These circumstances, while very unfortunate, are inevitably an important moment of learning for us. Now more than ever, we see how the world outside of our high school bubble is harsh and unforgiving. And we will only experience this more and more as we move outside into the world. Simultaneously, though, we see how people can support and aid one another, and how, above all, love rises up. High school, and by extension Sharpsville, was very good to us. We were surrounded by caring teachers and a strong sense of community. We leave this protective area, though, and we instead enter a more merciless world. In this turbulent time, we've become especially aware of the many dangers of the world. Many of us will also lose the protection of our parents who guided us to this point. And a thank you must be directed towards our parents and guardians, as without their help, we never would have developed into the adults we are very quickly becoming. Additional thanks go out to the teaching staff, who for many of us have been a second family. Your guiding hand and support have left a mark on us that we will never forget. As we leave into a seemingly harsh world plagued by countless issues, we must also not forget the love and teamwork that permeates our society. Once again, in this trying time, there's much trouble, but many people are also rising to the occasion. We see the charitable, kind hearts of our world now more than ever. And although we have lost so much to the virus, we've also gained fantastic insight that we will surely carry with us for the rest of our lives. Going out into the world, we must adopt the love and kindness that we have seen around us. And through this, we can leave a lasting mark. Change is occurring all over, and the world is the most malleable that it has been in a long time. With us coming of age and starting to be able to make change, we must seize this opportunity to improve the world around us and spread messages of love. We must choose, as we move forward, to remember what our sense of community has taught us, rather than succumbing to hate and prejudice. Kindness and love will guide us forward, and we will surely keep on pushing for the improvement of our world. To close, we are leaving into a world that seemingly has no sympathy for us, and we have gone out on a sour note. Despite this, there is still love to be found around every corner, and our anticlimactic ending to high school has served to teach us this. I know that we will always be welcomed and loved at Sharpsville, and I want to thank Mr. Vannoy, Ms. Houck, Ms. Marshall, Mr. Fry, our counselors, and our teaching staff. Without them, we would not be where we are today, and they have shaped us into the people that we have become. While not T.S. Eliot, I wish to end with a quote from Mary Ann Evans, otherwise known as George Eliot. She has said that our deeds determine us as much as we determine our deeds, and how we determine our deeds will be more and more important as we move on to the next phases of our lives in this ever-changing world. Thank you so much.
Our valedictorian graduating first in the class is William Divins. William plans on attending Penn State University's Chenango campus to major in actuarial science. Ladies and gentlemen, William Divins.
I am very nervous to make this speech, but if I'm up here, I might as well make it one to remember. All right. Let me paint you a picture. You are cramming to study for your final in mathematics with one of your best friends. You procrastinate, goof off, and get sidetracked, and then you come to the realization that your final is literally in 12 hours. So you start cramming, and then boom, you take the final, you hope you don't fail, you get the results back, and then boom, you end up getting a D in the class, almost failing your final. True story. Happened to me in my statistics class my junior year. How on earth am I supposed to do my major if it revolves around doing something that involves applied advanced statistics, considering I can barely not fail in my high school class? After I took the test, I was told that I was ranked number one in the class. Great, a kid ranked first that almost failed his final. Anyways, it wasn't until my senior year that I realized I needed to be motivated and determined in everything I do, in schools, academics, and even in my part-time job. After this wave of realization hit me, I decided I was going to try something new. I decided to try out for the boys' soccer team. Although I joined halfway through the season, yeah, I know that's a little bit late, but you know, fashionably late. I was probably one of the best soccer players on the team, to be honest. I learned almost everything there is to learn, and I scored in every single game I played in. Now, from what I told you, that is the way that you perceive my ability. It makes it seem as if I'm the best player to ever join a soccer team. However, by saying I know almost everything, I mean I learned how to differentiate a function on the sidelines, and by saying I scored in every single game I played in, I played in one game against a girls' team, and I accidentally kicked the ball to the girl, and she accidentally tripped over the ball, and it went inside the goal. Yeah, it was fantastic. True story. The true reason that I decided to join the team was because of my friends, and they encouraged me to play. It was what made it memorable, and that's really all that matters. Although I did not like soccer, I'm glad that they encouraged me to try it. However, it showed me something that I did not like, which is better than not trying it at all. Anyways, ever since I was younger, I wanted to be an engineer, you know, like building with Legos and stuff. Then I took physics my senior year. It was a very interesting class, good for someone that wants to pursue a degree or future in physics or engineering. However, it just wasn't meant for me. especially after I broke his flying pig in class. I am so sorry about that, Mr. Parents. Although I did not enjoy playing soccer or taking physics, I am certainly glad that I did. There is a lesson to be learned here. Do not be afraid to try something, even if it seems hard and if you don't want to do it. All joking aside, the class that motivated me the most was probably AP Language. The only thing that was horrible was the summer homework. I procrastinated to do that just like I procrastinated to make this valedictorian speech, especially considering that it was 5 days late. What we had to do for summer homework was to read a book and write a report about it. The book that I chose was When Breath Becomes Air by Paul Kalanisi. I hope I said that right. Not only did I not want to do the homework, but it was related to the medical field, which is something I had no interest in whatsoever. After the first 20 pages, I couldn't put the book down. The book is a memoir of the author who was a brain surgeon battling cancer. Yet instead of giving up, he decided that he was not only going to keep enjoying his life, but he was going to continue living his life to the fullest. There was occupation, which was performing brain surgery. The book was powerful because it highlights that you should not sit down and give up when everything gets hard and seems impossible. Rather, stand up, keep fighting, even stronger than you have ever before. Although this situation is not nearly the same as this class, the class of 2020 is facing, we are also facing the impossible. Finishing the remainder of the school year was devastating, considering that prom was canceled. Well, it is getting postponed. Graduate is not nearly what we expected it to be, and those last few moments with classmates and teachers that have been with us the past 4 years have been stripped away from us. Yet, despite all that has happened, we are all still here, graduating as a class, united as one. Probably the most influential quote from the book is actually at the end of the book, which exclaims, quote, Do not, I pray, discount that you filled a dying man's days with a sate of joy, a joy unknown to me in all my prior years, a joy that does not hunger for more and more, but rest, satisfied, quote. Our class is not resting with a sate of joy. They're going out into the world seeking a deeper meaning and a better understanding of the world. Whether it's through a college degree, enlisting in the military, going to a trade school, business school, or even going out to the workforce, we are all seeking that deeper meaning. I know that each and every one of us will be successful in one way or another. Success is different for every single one of us. Just like my perception on the soccer field, we all perceive things differently, just like success. I know for a fact that despite the way that perception of success is seen, everyone will be successful if they put their mind to it. I would like to thank all my teachers that have made a positive impact on my life. Despite everything that we have been through, they've been there for furthering my education even in times like this. The teachers here are incredible, as well as the students, staff, and environment. I'm thankful to be a Blue Devil and to be graduating with you at the class of 2020. It's been real. Thank you for your time. I would like to thank my parents, family, and classmates and teachers for all the support they have given me throughout my 4 years of high school. Thank you.
Our presentation of awards. The following students have earned an A for their final grade for all 4 years of high school. Please stand to be recognized. So when your name's called, stand up. Jared Clementson, William Divins, Shauna Hartwick, Bridget Mazant, James Misavage, Aaron Stevenson, Joshua Stevenson. These students will have their names added to the honors plaque outside of the main office in the high school lobby. Let's give them a round of applause. On June 4th, 2020, awards and scholarships for the class of 2020 were announced. We would like to recognize all students who have earned a scholarship to further their education. At this time, if your name was called during the awards scholarship ceremony, please stand. Let's give them a round of applause. You guys can be seated. The following students will be serving in a branch of the military serving our country upon graduation. Please stand and be recognized as your name is called and remain standing until you are asked to be seated. Serving her country in the United States Army, Demira Caldwell. Yeah. serving his country in the United States Marines, Austin McFeeters. Serving his country in the United States Marines, Lance Palmer. We would not be here today sending our graduates to pursue their own American dreams without those who have served before them, securing not only that dream, but also our freedom to live and worship the way we believe we should. Will all those brave men and women who have served or who are currently serving please stand to be recognized with our students entering the military. Well, all those in attendance and who are able to rise and honor these women and men, thank you for your service and sacrifice. You may now be seated. I would next like to call Emma Haywood and Richard Pizer to perform Imagine.
Thank you.
I apologize, we did miss Carson Smith. He is also in a branch of the military. Carson, will you please stand? He is joining the U.S. Navy, and I apologize for that mistake. Mr. Vinoy, the Sharpsville Area Board, the Pennsylvania Department of Education, set certain standards for graduation from high school. I hereby certify that all the students listed as the class of 2020 in our program and sitting before you now have met these standards and deserve to be awarded a diploma at graduation of Sharpsville Area High School.
Thank you, Mrs. Howard. As the superintendent of the Sharpsville Area School District, I accept your recommendation and congratulate the class of 2020. Good evening, administration, Board of Education, faculty, family, friends, and most importantly, you, the class of 2020. The Pines are such a great venue for graduation. Nothing beats the Pines on a Friday night. I'd like to thank the board for all their support. When we started this pandemic weeks ago, you know, it was a goal to have graduation, and I kept them updated on the progress. So I just want to thank them for the support in helping make tonight possible. Now, I always held out that we would do this, whether it was going to be in June or July. I was willing to wait it out. Thomas Paine from the American Revolution fame once stated, "These are the times that try one's souls." We've been living proof of this quote the past 14 weeks. Some things are truly worth the wait. Throughout our nation's history, there have been landmark events or dates that have defined our ancestors, whether that be the American Revolution, the Civil War, World War I, the Great Depression, World War II, the Civil Rights era, or 9/11, just to mention a few. How much have our lives changed in the past 98 days? That's a rhetorical question. I think everyone knows the answer to that. It was 14 weeks ago today, on March 13, 2020, that Governor Wolf at approximately 3 p.m. announced the closing of our schools across the Commonwealth. Staff and students left that day in a shroud of mystery. Our world and our lives were suddenly turned upside down. What happened in the educational world in a matter of a few short days was nothing short of amazing. Our staff was quickly able to transition from the traditional school setting to a digital platform. Suddenly, terms like Classroom Dojo, Google Hangouts, Remote Learning, Zoom, Class Tag, Tour Builder, Quizlet, Zern, and Screencastify became common educational jargon. Social distancing, quarantine, what's essential versus what's non-essential, wash your hands, masks, gloves, have all become too familiar aspects of our daily lives. It's like everyone was on vacation and there was nowhere to go. The unity and Blue Devil pride that has been displayed is amazing. Sincere thanks to all of our staff for taking us into a new educational universe. In addition, special thanks to you as the parents and guardians for the support and patience in helping the educational process. Thank you to our students for embracing the change that was forced upon you. Living rooms became classrooms. The lessons we are learning will make our school stronger and better once we return to whatever normal is going to look like and whenever that is. A special shout out to our proud alumni that were scheduled to graduate this spring. Congratulations and best of luck. I wish you nothing but the best in all of your future endeavors. A shout out as well goes to Mr. Aaron Meredith for organizing our first ever Facebook Live graduation ceremony. Mr. Meredith, thank you. Thank you to the maintenance staff, our senior class advisors, Mrs. Springer and Mrs. Saylor, and Mrs. Hopp for leading the class of 2020 to the finish line. Now, to our class of 2020, where do I ever begin with you? I feel for each and every one of you. So much has been taken away. It's been a fun ride these past 13 years. Granted, there have been peaks and valleys along the way. It must be an evening to recognize the Beatles, because just like we had a song by the Beatles, I have a quote from the Beatles. They had a song entitled The Long and Winding Road. This has been a long and winding road, not just for our seniors, but seniors across our great nation. You entered the world on the heels of 9/11 and now live the world of COVID-19. Your K-12 educational journey started back in the fall of 2007, and it culminates this evening. As you near the end of fifth grade, I began to hear about what was called, quote, that class. And at that time, I was the middle school principal, and that's all I heard was, that class is coming. I said, okay, just like classes that have preceded them, you know, what's going to make them any different? What made them different is every single day they came to work in school and worked hard and grew from day one of middle school all the way up through this evening. At that time, Mr. Dieter, who was the elementary principal, asked me, did I want to know anything about the incoming class? I said, no, because I believe what's in the past is just that. It's in the past. It's time for them to start a new chapter in middle school, just like after tonight, it's time to start a new chapter in your life. This group has never looked back. They are now ready to take on the world. After this evening, you'll begin to travel that road that I call the real world highway. Your 720 days of high school have now come to an end. I'd like to share some steps for success, a top 10 as you may. Think big, find what you love and do it. Learn how to balance life. Don't be afraid of failure. Have the will to succeed. Be a person of action, avoid conflict, have a positive attitude. Hard work is hard, but it does pay off, and follow your dreams. These are life lessons that will serve you well on a daily basis. What once seemed like light years away is now here. I would ask all of my fellow alumni to please stand for the remainder of my speech. So graduates of Sharpsville, please stand. Class of 2020, you now join the long list of alumni of the Sharpsville Area School District. As a proud graduate of the class of 1984, I am proud to take the opportunity to welcome you into our distinguished group of graduates. When you leave this field this evening, a new chapter of your life awaits you. This will be the final time your class is together as a group. You are well prepared for the challenges that lie ahead. Stay positive, work hard, take time to celebrate your successes, and build lifelong memories of these events. This experience will make you much better in years to come. On behalf of the school district and community, I wish you the best of luck. Remember not to forget your roots. Once a Blue Devil, always a Blue Devil. Congratulations, and you certainly added your collective footprint to the legacy of our district, and for that, I thank you. I'd like to call on High School Principal Ms. Haupt to call the roll of members in the class of 2020.
At this time, I would ask the first row of students to please stand. And I would also ask for our board members at this time to move to their position at the 50-yard line. Okay, Roland, where do you start? William Lynn Divins III. James Bradley Misavage. Jared David Clementson. Joshua Paul Stevenson. Shauna Lee Hartwick. Emma Cassidy Haywood. Row one, you may now be seated. Row two, please stand. Jacob Lee Thompson. Catherine Brooke Adams. Joseph Michael Alfredo. Raymond Patrick Allison Jr. Noah Patrick Amrine. Jessica Irene Anzer. Kalina Ray Arthurholt. Stephen Patrick Bartholomew Jr. Dylan Michael Bertolaccio. Liam Bosnum. Jaden Luke Boyd. Dominique Maria Brown. Demira Juanita Caldwell.
Yeah, Demira.
Wyatt James Caldwell. Row 2, you may now be seated. Row 3, please stand. Alex Nicholas Carroll. Catherine Elizabeth Shute. Tyler William Clary. Macy K. Dinger. Jacob Daniel Disler. Teresa Joy Elliott. Matthew Joseph Enos. Noah Alexander Flaherty. Francesca Marie Flynn. Alyssa Marcia French. Braden Michael Fry. Cameron Tyler Fry. Cassandra Nicolette Fry. Tori Paige Gearhart. Silas Matthew Paul Gert. Brianna Nicole Hast. Third row, you may be seated. Fourth row, please stand. Caleb Cole Hahn. Anna Nicole Harriet. Zachary Matthew Herman. Jacob Tyler Hogue. Kimberly Marie Holmes Raytai. Brandon Alexander Hobson. Alexis Brooke Hunter. Richard L. Hutchison. James Douglas Joseph. Seth Dwayne Knopf. Caleb James Kowacek. Allison Elizabeth Krem. Justin Michael Carolco. Hannah Nicole Lasher. Tabitha Grace Leitner. Caleb Michael Leinberger. Fourth row, you may be seated. Fifth row, you may please stand. Amber Marie McGee. John Allen Marson. Megan Alexis Masato. Grace Lillian Maurice. Bridget Raquel Mazant. Austin Taylor McFeeters. Dustin Joseph McGaughey. Macy Lyra Milius. Lance Midnight Palmer. Richard Lee Pizer. Maya Jane Wrestley. Molly Renee Rimko. Jessica Lynn Rust. Griffin Lewis Sable. Maxine Paige Shell. Zachary Edward Shealy.
All right.
Oh. Fifth row, you may be seated. Sixth row, please rise. Skylar Isaiah Thomas Scoobish. Riley Marie Sloan. Brayden Mikkel Smiley. Carson Brock Smith. Madeline Jane Elizabeth Smith. Taylor Ann Sowash. Claire Louise Staunch. Aaron Jacob Stevenson. Chase Jacob Stevens. Zane Francis Stewart. Max J. Tiber. Taylor Jean Tonti. Philip James Tulip. Hannah Jane Van Dyke.
Hannah!
Willow Irene Wagner.
Willow!
Darren Scott Ward. Allison Leanne Wilt. Row 6, you may be seated. Let's give the class of 2020 a big round of applause. Before we end, I would like to provide just a few words to the class of 2020. To the class of 2020, I would like to start off by saying thank you for our hardworking students and families. Through these past 12 years, and particularly the last 3 months, you have persevered. Your strength, determination, and vision on the future has brought you to the point in your educational journey. As the high school principal, I am very proud of your accomplishments and watching as you have had to adapt and change quickly to the world around you. Your time here at Sharpsville High School has come to a close, but the adventures of life are awaiting you. The next phase of life you are about to enter will be full of experiences beyond what you can imagine currently. I encourage you to continue to prepare for those future hopes, dreams, and experiences. May the leverage of your youth and the opportunities life presents you allow you to be who you want to be. Remember, you hold the keys to your future. In closing, your class quote is, "When you think about the last 4 years, you'll probably remember your greatest lessons came from outside the classroom." It's a good reminder that learning doesn't stop just because you received a diploma. I hope you do just that and are a lifelong learner. Well done, class of 2020. Let me wish you all the best for the future. My thoughts and prayers are with you. And at this time, I would ask all parents and guardians of our students to please rise and remain standing for the tassel ceremony. Parents and guardians, we all know and understand the significance of the ceremony, and this day marks an important milestone in your lives. Your sons and daughters stand before you ready to enter their adult life. We want you to know that all of your efforts throughout the years are recognized by the school and these students. Will the staff and students present please join me in offering a heartfelt appreciation for all that you have done? So students, let's give our parents a round of applause. Turning the tassel signifies the ending of their high school careers and the beginning of their adult life. I call on senior class president Emma Haywood one last time to lead this class in a symbolic gesture to you, our parents and guardians. On the count of three, Emma, whenever you're ready. 1, 2, 3. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to present to you the Sharpsville High School Class of 2020.